Best has actually been there. He's been blogging festival reviews since 2009, having since driven over 20,000 miles in almost every county in Ohio, if not every county.
And he has logged a lot of miles. You've been to festivals about skunks, Dean Martin, sauerkraut, and more. We're now joined by Christian Campana, who is preparing to document his 300th festival at the Worcester Festival of Trees this month. Christian, welcome. Thanks so much for being here.
Thanks for having me.
So how long have you been doing this?
Since 2009. So this is my fifth year officially.
How many do you go to on average a year?
I think it's around, I'm going to guess 60 just because 50. But in 2010, I went to 101. So that sort of like helped my average.
That's a full-time job.
Yeah,
I mean, really?
It got me around, yeah.
You know, the Dean Martin Festival is in Steubenville. I assume that's where you've been when you talk about the Dean Martin Festival. You know, and we were talking in the break about some of your favorites. Mm-hmm. There is so much, I think, to offer here in Ohio festival-wise because we get, you know, messages at work about them all the time. You read about them online. What sticks out? What are some of your favorites?
The Pawpaw near Athens is great. It's an indigenous fruit of Ohio. They have pawpaw beer and foods, and it's a nice feel to it. Comfest in Columbus, it's sort of a community sort of hippie fest. Skunk Fest in North Ridgeville, German American out in Oregon near Toledo. I mean, these are just a few, and such great foodie fests, historical fests, just quirky fests. I mean, even locally, Duct Tape in Avon.
Yeah,
I mean, just something eccentric, fun for the family, and just different.
And you blog about all of this. You were saying that it's hard if you don't come back, write about it right away, you start to forget.
Right, they start to blur together. I mean, there were weekends where I went to about 12 in one weekend.
12 in one weekend.
And I'm meeting people, meeting vendors, taking cards, because I like to put their websites on there too, so people were interested. So I'm writing on the cards which festival did I see them at, just so I can keep everything in track for a while.
I would think one of the things that makes a festival really stand out is when they take advantage of like the super local things that they have to offer, like the Maple Fest and things like that. You know, when they take advantage of what's in their own backyard, right?
Right. I mean, if you drive, especially for people coming out of state and everything, if you drive like 100 miles or even 50 miles, you want to be able to find, like, you don't want to make it seem that you could just go into your local Heinen's or your Kroger's or Giant Eagle and find the same products. You know, you want to find something that's really special, and oftentimes the local vendors are what makes it special.
Any reason why the Worcester one is coming up next?
Just timing and everything, but it's really nice too because it's sort of an end of the year festival. It's sort of Christmas time. My birthday's Christmas Eve, so it's a nice thing for me. So
there you are. Is that a banana?
Oh yeah, and the Banana Split Festival in Wilmington, and that's
Is that ice cream?
Yeah, there you go.
You like
have a little
one.
Like Sunday bar and everything. You can make it to your liking and everything. It's really cool.
There you are.
With that one.
Yeah, and this is a pie eating contest at the Berlin Heights Basket Festival. This is where I learned that even I'm just not good at eating contests at all, no matter what.
Does it seem like Ohio has an abundance of festivals?
More so, it really
does. Than other states?
I try to look at other states' festival sites just to find a number.
Yeah.
And I don't find anything near. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, I've also found not as many Ohio festival sites or festivals on other websites than my own, because I've really done a good job as far as collecting them all.
By the way, I think a lot of people don't take advantage of these festivals like they should. I mean, it's a great, a lot of them are obviously very family friendly, a lot of them are beer related, you know, things along those lines too for adults, but it's just a great opportunity, I think, to really see what our state has to offer.
Right, I mean, it's a celebration, it's getting together with people, it's community, everyone's there for a good reason. It also gives you an excuse to explore a city you wouldn't otherwise have gone to, and like going, this is really cool. And like, you go to Medina, the cute little downtown Medina, they have a hot dog place and put Fritos and chili on the dog. I'm like going, I have to come back here for some more. This is great. You know, just things like that.
Yeah.
And Christian, tell us really quick before we wrap, how can people find your blog online?
OhioFestivals.net is the website. All you have to do really is type Ohio Festivals in any Google site, and it's one of the first things that pop up. Look for Funnel Cake. This is kind of logo down here. And there's a festival schedule page. You can find everything listed by weekend. There's a search bar. You could look up certain blogs festivals if I've already been there. It should be fairly easy.
Good deal. And I believe we also put a link to that on our website, box8.com, in case you forget. Thank you so much for being here.
Thanks for having me. It's a real pleasure.
Yeah, we appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
Nice meeting you.
Nice meeting you, too.
I like the idea of the funnel cakes and eating
They
and
all
ice
sound
cream.
Fun.